Whether you realize it or not, frequency and vibration hold an extremely important yet hidden power that affects our lives, our mental and physical health, and our consciousness. The science of somatics, which is the study of visible sound and vibration, proves that vibration and frequency are the organizational foundation for the creation of all matter and life. When sound waves move through a physical medium, such as land or water, the frequency of the waves has a direct effect upon the structures, and this works within the human body as well. To better understand the power of sound frequency, let's discuss the Chladni plate experiment, named after the German physicist and musician who made this concept visible. In his famous experiment, he showed how moving a violin bow against a metal plate covered with sand could visually display the movement of sound. The sand concentrated in areas where the plate was not vibrating. Through his work, he was able to conclude that sound, or frequency, travels in waves, and he was the first scientist to clearly demonstrate this connection. Take a look at these images to see how different frequencies create different effects to the structures of the sand. As the pitch of the tone increases, geometric patterns form and become more complex. One of the most important frequencies that you may hear of often is that of 432 Hertz. Hertz refers to the number of vibrations or cycles per sound. So why is this frequency so important? Everything has a range of frequency, including every organ and cell in our bodies. Scientific research has shown that our cells resonate with and respond to different frequencies. Music based on 432 Hertz creates resonance within our bodies and balances the emotional and mental state. But you may be surprised to know that our current musical standard is a tuning of 440 Hertz. So when did this concert pitch come into effect? Most music worldwide has been tuned to 440 Hertz since the International Standards Organization, or the ISO, endorsed it in 1953. There is a theory that the change from 432 Hertz to 440 Hertz followed the recommendations of the Nazi Party spokesman, Joseph Goebbels, in 1939. According to this theory, there was an organized effort to change concert pitch to 440 Hertz at the start of the last century to codify an old world new order of central pitch. This was set into motion in order to increase anxiety levels in individuals, causing them to think and feel in specific ways. It's also alleged that the Rockefeller Foundation had an interest in making sure the United States adopted the 440 Hertz standard as a part of a war on consciousness, causing more emotional distress and in turn more physical illness and hardship. Whether these theories are true or not, one thing is certain. The frequency that music is tuned to has a profound effect on us. This is not just a spiritual concept, it's mathematically and scientifically proven. And because most of us listen to music often and have a way to plug that directly into our ears, it's a great idea to deliberately use specific frequencies as often as possible. Referring back to the plate experiments, here are the differences that these two frequencies make when used. The 432 Hertz seems to show a much cleaner and more organized structure. Many people have described similar perceptions over their individual experience of 432 and 440. But some who are not able to distinguish the 8 Hertz difference claim that they feel 432 Hertz as a warmer, richer, fuller experience that just feels better to them because of the longer wavelength. And there are videos on YouTube where you can hear the differences in specific music tuned to 432 or 440. Nikola Tesla stated, "The brain and the earth itself work on the same frequencies. If we can control that resonant system electronically, we can directly control the entire mental system of humankind."
Hello everyone, it's End Times Talk coming at you with a brand new video. Today we're going to be talking about the zombie phenomenon. Weren't those two videos interesting? The first one, you know, was about frequencies and the damage that they can do, but also the positive things that they can do. One thing I want to mention about the Bible is it talks about in the book of Genesis how when Cain slew Abel, all right, it says that God heard Abel's blood crying out from the ground. I do believe Abel's blood, the first of its kind, was sending out a frequency to God, and he heard it. Okay, so I think frequencies very much so are important. You know, there's some of us out there, you know, who get that ear ringing, you know. Some of us that are from the 70s, 80s, and 90s, you know, we grew up with tube televisions, you know, where it was this big hunky clunky television, and they had a definite ring to them when they turned on, especially if there was nothing being played on them. And so some of us are very much more sensitive to frequencies than other people. Me, myself, being one of those people, I can most definitely hear those older TVs when they're on. It gives me a headache. I mean, it'll wake me up out of a sound sleep and just give me a throb and pounding headache. And so their frequencies definitely are something that can cause, you know, even aching and pains, all right? And so we have to remember, you know, this whole new 5G stuff, I mean, it was, the whole world was very resistant to it. And right around the same time, you know, that 5G started to be passed out around the globe, a lot of the things that, you know, we dealt with for 2 years happened. And so it's very interesting that around the same time people are dealing with the effects of 5G. And if you look up the effects of like radiation from electronics and stuff, a lot of the same symptoms are very obvious with other things as well. And so, you know, you're going to have to do your own research with that, because there's only so much I can tell you on the YouTube platform. Anyways, you know, 5G is very much so a powerful tool. I want you to check this video out. Isn't that crazy? Even the was moving around and all that stuff. All right. That's crazy to me. All right. I mean, when he was making the call and the 5G was active, all right, that's when it started moving around. All right. And you wouldn't even believe what that stuff is in. All right. So anyways, you know, it's definitely a obvious thing that cellular devices, 5G, you know, these cellular companies, all this Bluetoothing equipment, all this different stuff that's on this level of 5G, you know, is having an effect on us. Is it good? Is it bad? That's up for you to decide. I'm not going to be that person and tell you, but I am going to give you my opinion and what I feel is coming ahead. And I do believe we're going to be dealing with a false flag zombie apocalypse. And I know that that sounds kind of weird, and there's not too many people out there that have even talked about such a thing. But I know that when you look at the definition of what a zombie is, it's a reanimated corpse that's literally brought back by witchcraft, all right? And some witchcraft that definitely comes from like the Caribbeans and like the Haiti area, you know, like voodoo and things like that. A lot of that stuff is tied to demonic power and things like that. But there's also a lot of other things being given to people on this globe that's tied to demonic power. So that's all I'll say about that. Anyways, but a zombie is a reanimated corpse that's reanimated through witchcraft, all right? That's what the definition is on Google. And so I definitely think that there's something to this. And but I do believe that they're going to make it look like there's a zombie apocalypse. But I don't honestly necessarily believe that it's going to be the reanimated dead that are going to be coming back and that are going to get super, super violent. I think through electronic means, and anybody who takes the mark of the beast is going to be connected to this 5G and coming 6G system, okay? And anybody that's connected to that can be controlled by frequencies, okay, that are coming that comes through the RFID microchip, the radio frequency identification chip. Here it is here. it's crazy how they're rolling this stuff out on us, you know, and they're even telling us in movies that they could, that they're going to use frequency and even chemical agents and things like that, that they're going to cause people to become violent and zombie-like. All right. I want to show you some of these films and trailers that are promoting this sort of stuff. Now, I'm going to tell you, and I'm going to give you fair warning here, okay? These videos that I'm showing you are not to scare you, okay? It's to prepare you, all right? And some things are a little rough that we have to see. Though there are some things that are really bad that I'm going to block out. But you know, this video, the rest of this video is not for baby Christians, okay? This video is for mature Christians only, and honestly, mature audiences only, because we're talking about a subject matter that I believe is coming upon the earth that's very serious.
He leaves in about an hour.
Clay, you've been gone for over a year. I love you, but it's not that simple.
I'd like to see my son.
Our time's up.
I need more money.
It to be that effective.
What kind of response are we talking to?
100%.
So everyone's been affected, whether they have a SIM card or not. And we get the added benefit of wiping out the kingdom.
Not yet.
I will tell you that, you know, we're in a food shortage situation as a country, whether people really realize it or not yet. The food is there, but it's just barely there. It's dwindling. And so it's not going to take much more time before things get really rough in the food shortage department. And I can tell you from research that I've done from other dictatorships that have taken over, you know, like with Stalin, Joseph Stalin in Russia. I mean, I'm not going to even lie. It took 2 weeks for people to start cannibalizing, okay? And I think that they have primed people for cannibalization, all right? The New York Times let out a Instagram tweet that has them talking about, you know, is it time for cannibalism? Is it something people can handle talking about? You know, they're making it sound like it's some trendy thing that's coming upon the earth in the future. Well, we know all the celebrities are involved in eating human flesh, and that it's part of the, say, if you're part of the Satanic Club, you sure know that these people are involved in eating human flesh at parties and things like that, and during satanic ritual and drinking adrenochrome and the blood and all that stuff. And so anyways, they're pushing cannibalism on the world. They got movies like bones and all, that's a horrific movie. I won't even show it on here, that has to do with cannibalism and people cannibalizing each other. It's evil. You know, they have other movies out there as well where they push this agenda for so long. And so I do believe that they're going to cause a frequency to happen nationwide, worldwide, I don't know. But I do believe that they're going to use cellular devices, okay, even specifically cellular devices, to send out a frequency or even the microchip that they're going to plan on putting in everybody's hand. And even a lot of people are already getting. There's well over 3-4 million people microchip with this thing. And so they have a lot of numbers that are growing. I mean, you can walk into some tattoo shops that are very leftist tattoo shops, and you can literally get your RFID chip there at a tattoo shop. It's crazy. And so they're pushing this stuff hard. And I think when they flip that switch and they send out a specific frequency that interfaces with the human brain, that can cause the human brain to go nuts and violent and get agitated really quickly. And you saw in that video I showed earlier in the beginning of this video where they're talking about how frequencies can affect attitude and can agitate people and all that stuff. So I do believe that this is a very real scenario.
So you see this document right here? This is an actual government document that was received in a Freedom of Information Act request from a U.S. Fusion Center. Fusion Center? What's that? You should probably look those up. There's 78 of them in the United States. Now, what that document shows is how human beings can be connected with electronically. You know, say if somebody were to be implanted with an RFID chip. That stands for Radio Frequency Identification. Kind of like how your cell phone connects to a cell phone tower. So if one of those were implanted into your body, maybe they could connect with your body like a cell phone. You notice how I said maybe sarcastically. So if you think this is some kind of conspiracy nonsense thing, here's the article in Popular Mechanics showing how this document was acquired. And in the article, it explains how humans can be connected with different technology. I'm not just sharing this because it sounds neat. It's the reason my eyes look like this.
It says right here in Albert Pike's Three World Wars letter, okay, and I want to read this to you, and this is a very accurate document, okay, and I say this, but we've made other videos on this. Anytime we're talking about World War III, we usually bring up this letter, okay, and I believe we're in the beginning stages of World War III, and so I believe that this letter definitely applies to what's going on, and I want to read the Third World War to you, the paragraphs about the Third World War. There's only 4 paragraphs here. They're rather small. I want you to hear this so that way you can apply this to some of the films that you've just seen. The Third World War must be fermented by taking advantage of the differences caused by the agents of the Illuminati and between the political Zionists and the leaders of the Islamic world. The war must be conducted in such a way that Islam, the Muslim Arabic world, and political Zionism, the State of Israel, mutually destroy each other. Now listen to this. Meanwhile, the other nations, once more divided on this issue, will be constrained to fight to the point of complete physical, moral, spiritual, and economical exhaustion. And even just some of the last videos that I've made, I've been talking about how they've really been trying to exhaust God's people and wear us down. But listen to this, and you really got to pay attention to this. It says right here, we shall unleash the nihilists and the atheists, and we shall provoke a formidable social cataclysm, which in all its horror will show clearly to the nations the effects of absolute atheism, the origin of savagery, and of the most bloody turmoil. That right there, I believe, is the coming false flag zombie apocalypse, okay? I believe that they are going to cut people loose on each other in a purge-style fashion where the power could go out and they send a signal out at the very end, or they're sending a signal constantly to people that aren't, that you know, that are connected in some way through this Mark of the Beast technology. All right, I'm telling you people, all right, it's very possible that the lights will go out and this stuff could start to happen, or it could happen with the lights on. I'm just trying to say it's very possible that the lights could go out. I do believe that a formidable social cataclysm is on its way, and they want Americans to cut loose on Americans. They want neighbor against neighbor. They want father against son. They want mother against daughter. They want kids against their parents. They want dissent. They want depravity. They want rebellion, all right? They want death. This is a death cult that is taken over, okay? And so people need to be prepared and be aware of these things in movies and media and all that stuff where they're telling us what they're going to do to us. I mean, you just saw earlier in this video, the scientific facts, you know, talking about how these frequencies affect people. All right. You've seen the video in the beginning of this video where you saw a man pouring out a stream of water in a frequency he kicked on, and it literally spiraled the stream. Okay. If a stream of water can be moved like this to act that crazy and can spiral, okay, what can it do to your brain when it hits your brain? So we need to be in alignment with God so that way when these things happen, it doesn't affect us, all right? If we have the Spirit of the Lord within us, these things aren't going to affect us. They can't touch us with this stuff, all right? When you have the Spirit of the Lord dwelling in you, that's that plain and simple, okay? There's nothing that's overtaking God within you, all right? When the Holy Spirit dwells in you, that's that. And when the Holy Spirit dwells in you, there's nothing that can that can cohabitate, all right? You cannot serve two masters, okay? Plain and simple. I truly believe it's going to be frequencies that are going to cause the false flag zombie apocalypse. And I believe that this is all part of depopulation. It's a depopulation agenda. All right. And especially, you know, they have all these purge movies that they've been making for so long, you know, pitting Americans against Americans and even foreigners coming into America to commit acts of violence during this 24-hour period of time where everything's legal in America. All right. And they're just going haywire on each other. Okay. I'm going to show you one of the trailers from one of the movies here called The Purge Election Year. Okay. And this is very serious, folks. I believe that they're telling us the truth, possibly, that during election year, there might even be something that happens. All right. So I'm not saying that 100% for sure, but they're definitely programming us and telling us what they're going to do to us with all this stuff. So I wanted to make you guys aware of what the true zombie situation is that's coming upon the earth. You know, the whole Walking Dead situation where there's like a virus that causes people to die and be reanimated. I just don't see that being possible, but I definitely see frequencies affecting the minds of men and women and causing them to turn on their family, their friends, and their loved ones, and even their neighbors. So I wanted to make this video and make you guys aware so that way you guys are not deceived. And I'm telling you, folks, get right with Jesus. Get right with him now, because I'm telling you, time is super short. All right. These things will come upon the earth. All right. This kind of violence is coming. And I want to make you guys well aware so that way when you stand before God, you can't say that you never knew. It's time to make a choice and it's time to strap in. The end times are here. May God bless you. May God keep you. And don't forget to go out and change the world in which you live.
Your emergency broadcast system announcing the commencement of the annual purge. At the siren, all crime, including murder, will be legal for 12 hours. All emergency services will be suspended. Your government thanks you for your participation.
What is this?